since the first dawn of knowledge, man has known that there was another parallel world close by his own. A world somehow like ours, but of incredible darkness and fear. It has been called many different names by many different cultures, but the shadowy legend of his dark mirror world persisted in the minds of men over the ages, and with it the terror that one day the fearful inhabitants of this dread world would somehow penetrate into our world.
Spare me the dreary details, William. Surely you can find something more pleasant in that fairy tale book.
Dr. Smith, this isn't a fairy tale book. This is a book about weird, unexplained legends of the past.
Idiotic folklore, that's what it is. Unsubstantiated drivel passed down by simple peasant mentalities.
Well, it may be folklore, but I'll bet there's a scientific explanation for everything in this book.
But before you delve too deeply into the scientific explanation, would you be good enough to fetch me a pillow from the ship? I feel the need of a brief nap.
All right.
Hustle along, William. The constant riffling of pages is hardly conducive to my quiet time. Besides, that ridiculous book will just clutter your mind with nonsensical nonsense. It's out there. Somewhere it's up there. I can feel it.
To the other world. One point in the entire universe where we can break free and pass over into their world.
We've got to find it.
And if we can, how do we know that we can get through?
An atomizing unit. We'll need an atomizing unit. And if it could reach sufficient power,
then we'll find our opposites. Force them to come back here. And we'll be free.
No, not you. Not this time. Mine's closest. I can feel it. If we cannot balance the energy intake with the atomizing unit, how are we ever going to get back into flight?
By studying the problem, I may be able to supply knowledge needed to construct a duplicate of the missing section.
It's all yours.
Completed the schematic. Double X minus zero. The task which remains must be carried to Y plus W2, the first step. Dr. Smith's off-key humming is disturbing my sensors.
Off-key indeed, you cackling clown. I can prescribe the perfect cure for your sensitive nervous system, the removal of your power pack.
I had reached the computed conclusion. Now it has been lost.
Doctor,
We'll never get those motors to working again until we get that schematic straightened out.
If it is that important, I suggest you do not leave it to the tender mercies of this mental midget.
I cannot continue my calculations with Dr. Smith's highly emotional outburst disturbing the immediate area.
Suppose you go inside. Maybe you can be of some assistance to my wife.
Zachary Smith relegated to the kitchen?
Yes, maybe you can toss a salad or something.
I refuse. I absolutely refuse.
Inside, Smith.
Very well. Just you wait.
All right, now.
Thank you, Professor Robinson. Now we can proceed with the most critical stage, the clearing of the chamber exhaust. But I cannot recommend that it be attempted.
It's got to be done.
The fuel temperature equalization is a highly delicate procedure. These units are still in a dangerously unstabilized condition.
I know, but it's a chance we'll have to take if we're ever going to get these motors repaired.
Very well.
Activate. Give me a temperature reading.
265. 300.
If we turn on this fuel output machine again and duplicate the same conditions, will we get Professor Robinson back?
Until we fully understand what has happened, I would strongly advise against any such action.
Well, we have to do something.
This problem involves space, time, and matter. It will take complicated computer effort to arrive at a solution.
Darn, it felt like an earthquake.
We better get back inside the ship.
No, we've got to stay here and try and get back Dad.
Well, there's nothing we can do until the robot works out the problem.
John Robinson. Everyone knows that.
Run! Where are we?
This is your home. You'll never leave it again. My friend is probably at the alternate meeting place. To get you here. And I need you for my plans. But that doesn't mean that I wouldn't kill you in a split second if you got in my way. You understand? If given a choice, I'd rather not have to kill part of myself.
The burden of guilt is mine. My senses warn me of the danger.
Goodness, it's been thundering and lightning for hours.
I wish it would rain or snow or whatever it's going to do and get it over with.
According to our weather instruments, there isn't any storm.
Mrs. Robinson, this strange climatic occurrence is the result of two worlds whose magnetic stability is out of balance.
And that, thank you, makes just about as much sense as our weather readings.
This atmospheric disturbance is tied in with the disappearance of Professor Robinson.
Well, can't you compute what's happened to him and help us get him back?
It is a very difficult computation. I would gladly burn out all my transistors to accomplish the professor's return.
I know. You're doing everything you can.
Well, we're not helping matters any by staying up and worrying. We might as well get to sleep. Maybe the robot will come up with some answers in the morning.
Come on, Mom.
took you long enough getting back here.
I had to wait for the right time.
He's your duplicate, all right. When do we get mine?
Soon.
I still don't think it's going to work.
It must work. We've been prisoners here far too long.
Thousands and thousands and thousands of years.
Prisoners? Aren't we all? Prisoners of our crimes and weaknesses? Now, Professor, we'll change clothes. Don't make us force you. Allow me to be the first to welcome you to your new world.
Sleep. I thought maybe you and I could work on what happened to Dad together.
So far, all my computations are just worthless spots on my computer tapes. I am a miserable failure.
Don't worry. You'll think of something. I know you will. You know, maybe Don was right. Maybe if we recreated the same situation as when Dad disappeared.
I do not believe that would bring your father back.
No, but it might send us to him.
No, Will Robinson. What you suggest is extremely dangerous.
Well, we have to do something. Suppose Dad's hurt and he needs our help.
A point well made. Activate the machines.
I knew you'd go with me.
Activate them.
Yes.
So am I. Displacement.
Well, where are we?
I will try to compute our surroundings. We are nowhere. This place does not exist anywhere in time or space.
But we're here. We have to be somewhere.
We are between any number of dimensions. If we were to fall into one of them.
Let's hope Dad didn't fall into one.
If he did, then he is lost forever.
take him back.
To return to our own planet.
Is that me?
A reflection of your negative self.
We sure are in a strange place.
I also wish to observe my appearance. Attractive I am.
You're a robot. You're supposed to be functional, not pretty.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the ugliest robot of all? Me. That is who.
Maybe your general appearance could stand a little improving, but that's not important. It's your character that counts. Generous and intelligent. You're just an all-around nice robot.
Yes, I do have certain appealing qualities. Who cares if I'm an ugly duckling on the outside?
That's the spirit. And now that we've solved that problem, can we go on?
If necessary, I will follow you to the very end of space itself, Will Robinson. Stop, Will Robinson. My computations tell me we have arrived. Antimatter world, the exact opposite of our universe.
Boy.
I also compute great danger there.
Maybe your sensors just aren't adjusted to that world yet.
I hope that is it. Will you take my hand again, Will Robinson?
Coincidence, but we left a place where it was thundering and lightning, and it's doing the same thing here.
This world is also out of balance.
I just hope we can find Dad and get out of here in a hurry. Dad! Dad, it's me, Will!
Robinson, there is something wrong here. Something very wrong.
If you ask me, everything in this whole world is wrong.
There's something more. I mean, the danger is all around us.
What I can see around us is a bunch of old rocks.
Tell them that. Immediate withdrawal is suggested.
Robot!
my feet! I can't move them!
Neither can I!
I can't move my head!
I can't either! This is a strange, strange world indeed! Rocks moving, and humans not able to!
I can hear them coming closer!
So can I! Let's not listen!
Right!
Returning to our home base will prove to be extremely difficult, Professor Robinson.
There's a departure place. Almost a bridge between here and home. I think I can get us back there.
You still have not told us what happened to you, Professor Robinson.
There was a magnetic imbalance. You saw that. And I don't know. I guess I was just teletransported here.
Yes, I was present during the magnetic imbalance. My scanners also detected another presence, someone who took you away with him.
Another person? You have a very vivid imagination, robot. There was no one else.
I am not programmed for imagination.
Perhaps there's something wrong with your scanning equipment. We'll have to check it out when we get back.
My scanners have just had their 25,000-hour checkup. They are in perfect working order.
Apparently they're not. There was no one else. But we can discuss that later. Right now, the important thing is for us to get home safely.
Dad's right, Robot.
Thank you.
This is the spot. Now, we're going to walk right into another dimension.
Which one?
Ours, I hope.
You're doing it, Dad! You're doing it! You did it!
We're very lucky, son.
Was it just a matter of chance, Professor Robinson?
And what's that supposed to mean?
It was merely a thought.
And we'd better check your tapes also. You're not programmed for thinking.
Darling! Oh, my goodness, I'm so glad you're back. I kept telling myself everything would work out all right, and I just didn't believe it. Oh, we were so worried, Dad.
Welcome back, John.
Well, Will and the robot deserve all the credit for getting me here. If it hadn't been for them, I'd still be lost.
Well, I think this rate's a celebration.
Oh, could we? I'll get my tape recorder and we'll have some music.
And as an extra treat, we can use some of the reserve food supplies.
Well, why not? After all, it is a special occasion.
Now, we have no time for parties. We must make our repairs and leave.
Why? What's the hurry? I mean, you're back safely now. I think that calls for a celebration.
We can't waste the time. We must leave immediately.
You know, if I didn't know about it, John, I'd say you were acting like a man on the run.
Yes, I guess you're right. I am a little jumpy. This whole affair has had its effect on my nerves.
Well, there's nothing better for a case of nerves than a good party. Come on,
we'll have a party.
Judy Robinson, could I speak to you for a moment?
We can talk at the party you're invited to.
No. I am not sure this is an occasion for happiness. How long has the thunderstorm been over?
Just a few minutes. It stopped about the time you, Will, and Dad returned.
The two worlds are once again balanced.
I don't understand what you mean.
When my sensors have reached a final conclusion, I will tell everyone.
I think it was a splendid party.
Oh. Ah, yes, indeed, madam. All things considered, the repast was truly a gourmet delight.
Now, how would you know that, Smith?
Spare me the poisonous barbs, Major. Zachary Smith has always traveled through the universe first cabin until this ill-fated journey.
Oh.
Well, now that we've all had our fill of fun and food, I suggest we get back to work.
Work? Madam, you must excuse me. I shall retire to my quarters and meditate.
Remain here!
Spit, your shift starts in a half hour.
A half hour? Evidently, you didn't understand me, Major. There's no half hour. Get to work immediately.
Oh. John, that's no way to talk.
When I want your advice, I'll ask for it. Don't you and Judy have something to do in the galley?
John.
Well, do it.
last thing I want to do is get in the middle of a family argument, but you were way off base with Marie just now.
I was a little hard on her. But it was for her own good. For the good of all of us. Look, I've seen that other place. I know the horrors of it. And how close it is and how it threatens us. And I'm gonna drive everyone in this group, myself included, to make all necessary repairs and leave here as soon as possible. And if at times I seem hard, even unsympathetic, it's because I'm concerned with the safety and welfare of us all. All right. Let's get back to work.
Right. Smith and I will take off. My watch is running backwards. Look. Second hand's going in the wrong direction.
I'll check mine. It's gone crazy, too. Dad, you know, you once told me that in space, time isn't measured by the minutes or the hours, but by the millions of years. Do you remember? Take a look at my recorder. There's something wrong with it.
Yeah, we'll fix it later, Penny. We've got a lot of work to do right now.
I hope you can see to it soon, because a recorder that runs backwards isn't of much good.
All right, we've wasted enough time. Let's get back to work. Haven't you finished working on that condenser yet? What's taking you so long?
Can't we finish dismantling this weather station in the morning?
We haven't got that much to do. If we finish tonight, we can devote the morning to getting the ship ready for pre-launch.
Well, what's the hurry? A couple of more days on this planet won't make much difference. Come on, let's call it a night.
Stay until you're finished, understand?
Take it easy, will you?
I'll take it easy when we're off this planet. Now get back to work.
Look, John, I know you've had a rough time of it, but that doesn't give you the right to lean on me.
You're shiftless, you're lazy, and you're worthless. Just like your opposite.
Opposite? Now, what are you talking about? What's the matter with you? You're acting like some kind of a...
You're right. Maybe I've been pushing too hard. Forgive me.
Opposite.
Will! I need you.
Watch, and Major West watch, too.
Are you trying to say he isn't my father?
He is. And then again, he is not.
You're not making any sense.
There are areas which are unclear to me also, Will Robinson. But I will tell you what I do know.
Well, go ahead. I'm listening.
I suspect that the man you believe to be your father is in reality an antimatter John Robinson from an antimatter world.
Antimatter?
We know that all matter has its opposite. This principle could also apply to individuals.
Two fathers? That's hard to believe.
Do you remember the storm which came up when Professor Robinson disappeared?
Sure.
It was caused by matter displacement. Both John Robinsons were in the same world.
And when we came back with my antimatter father, the storm stopped.
Because the balance between the two worlds had been restored.
Well, let's go wake everyone up and tell them.
No. All this is only theory on my part. I have no facts to back it up.
I'll give you a fact to back it up. We're going back into that antimatter world. We're going to find my real father and bring him back.
No, Will Robinson. It is much too dangerous.
Well, isn't it just as dangerous to leave this antimatter man here, pretending he's my father? We don't know what he's trying to do. He might want to kill us.
Either way is filled with danger.
I know that I can't leave my father in trouble without trying to help him. Now, will you come in with me? Or do I have to go alone?
My sensors compute extreme danger, but I cannot let you go alone.
Well, what? You're just about the best friend anyone ever had.
Friendship was one of the first virtues programmed into me.
Okay, let's go.
Remember, when you get to the antimatter world, wait for me. I will only be a moment behind you.
Don't worry. I'm not going anywhere alone if I can help it.
Stop!
Hurry, activate the engines!
Professor Robinson knocked you down?
Impossible.
It was not Professor Robinson. It was his antimatter self.
Antimatter self?
Good heavens, he's finally cracked. I've been expecting it.
Oh, I cannot waste time explaining to you. I must go to the antimatter world. Will Robinson is there.
Will? In the antimatter world?
Yes, he has gone to search for his real father.
Antimatter world, real father? What in the world are you talking about, you ninny? Major, even a simple mind like yours cannot believe all this nonsense.
Activate the atomic engine, Major.
Now look, robot, I know you're programmed for truthfulness, but you've been operating under quite a strain lately. Maybe your microcontrols are worn out or something.
Even if they were, you know my control mechanism is self-repairing. Major, you must activate the atomic engine. You must. You must.
All right, let's get him up.
Atomic engine, Major. Major, activate the atomic engine.
You don't believe him, do you? You, sir, stop this idiocy at once, do you hear?
Activate it, Major. Major, activate it. Now!
One more word out of you!
Exist.
Very well, you made your point, my dear friend. I believe you, I do. Get me out of here and back to the Jupiter immediately.
There is no time for that now. We must find Will and Professor Robinson first.
Why do these terrible things always happen to me? Why always to me? Always to me?
Of the real John Robinson.
That explains so many things. Well, where are John and Will now?
I don't know. Somewhere in the antimatter world, I guess.
Thank you.
him, and we can all return to the Jupiter. What is this?
The entrance to the antimatter world.
How do we get through it?
Our physical presence will probably cause it to open and admit us.
Take my hand.
Oh, all right. Occurs, causing violent electrical charges to be released.
But if both professors are here, how will we ever tell them apart?
It will not be difficult. One is good and the other evil.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Get away for now. But somehow I'll get out of here. And when I do, I'll hound you to the ends of the universe. That's a foolish outburst of bravado, Professor Robinson. It might tempt me to kill you now and have it done with. That's a bluff and you know it. You can't kill me. You need me. You need me to balance your entrance into the other world. Yes, I do need you here. To balance my escape while I return to the freedom of your world. And he won't escape either, will he?
No one escapes from the antimatter world.
Except us. Come, it's time to go to the Jupiter, too.
I told you, I'm not going anywhere with you.
Not only are you going back with me, but once we get there, you're not going to breathe one word about who I am or where the real John Robinson is.
The minute I get back, I'm going to tell everyone everything I know.
I don't think you'd be so foolish. Because once my true identity is known, my plans for escape will be ruined. And once they're ruined, I wouldn't have any reason to keep your father alive. Do you understand that?
I guess I do.
Then you'll behave and do exactly as you're told.
Get him back here.
I don't need any help. Come.
Stand guard here.
That's enough of that.
Sure, that's enough. I can just see him going to a whole lot of trouble to bring back your duplicate.
He will! I know he will!
Sure he will. And by the time you wake up to the fact that you've been double-crossed, he'll be at least two galaxies away from here.
I said for you to shut up!
You'll never get me with that chain!
I'm
What is it?
My sensors compute danger ahead.
Where are you going? You said there was danger ahead. Wait for me, you cowardly cop! Wait for me! Wait!
Expression. What are you doing time for, dumb? I am not doing time. I am in here by mistake. That's what they all say. And you? What are you in for? For being everything you're not. Untrustworthy, disloyal, unhelpful, unfriendly, rude, mean, disobedient, and all the rest of it. Got the picture? I am sorry for you. Don't be. If it weren't for me, you couldn't be you. This is the opposite world. You're free in your world. Therefore, I'm imprisoned here. Maybe if it had all happened differently, I could have been like you. The shining and bright and good one. But there must be something I can do to help you. I don't need anything from you, punk. Just get out of here while you can. Go on, scram, beat it. Get lost, Fink. Get lost. Goodbye. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low.
Planning to be around for quite a while.
That's exactly what I'm planning. So you'd better get used to seeing me around. After all, I am a member of the family.
I don't know what you are, but you're definitely not one of us.
Now, is that any way to talk to your father?
You're not my father.
I am.
You're not, and my real father's not gonna let you do this. He'll come after us. I just bet he will.
He'd better not. That would be a disaster. It would be as if a man were fighting against himself.
Well, I don't know about that, but I just know he's gonna come after us.
If
you love your father as much as you say you do, pray that he doesn't.
I can't tell you how good it is to be home.
Oh. I guess we're all lucky to be back here, Robot.
Ah, lucky indeed. If I hadn't had that fight with that alien, none of us would ever have come back here.
No, I wonder whatever happened to that antimatter man.
The worlds are once again in balance. Wherever he is in the antimatter world, and not here.
And a good thing, too. I should hate to have to fight all those dreadful people again.
Stay tuned for some exciting scenes from next week's show.
Now you've done it! You've launched the pod
into space! It's not responding. It's moving away from us!
Who are you? What have you done with my husband and Major West?
Next week, weird identical doubles threaten the Space Family Robinson.
I believe you wanted to talk to us.
Let's get him!
Do not resist, it is futile.
You know, I think you're trying to take over. And if you know what's good for you, you'll quit trying.
You threaten me. Just remember, underneath, you're no different than I am.
Now look!
Danger! Danger!
Next week, Target Earth on Lost in Space, here on this channel.